Hey everyone, Sir Jellybean here, and we are back with Court Arms Gates of Hell Ostfront, the Valor campaign, and it is back with Japan, the Imperial Army, the Rising Sun is going forth, and I'm here with Mr. Quicksilver. How are you doing, sir?
Hey guys, I'm doing great. Thanks for having me again.
He's a fantastic individual. Get over to his channel. There'll be a link in the description below. Some really good stuff. He is Lost Front player, and he plays Ultimate Admiral Dreadnought, I believe?
Absolutely, and probably a few others in the future.
He's up and coming. He's going to be playing a lot of stuff, and guys, definitely some good Ostfront content. I've really been enjoying this series. You'd be a fool to miss out. So, we'll get into what we researched last time. We did research Calling Stage 3. We also researched the Japanese tanks up to the Type 95 Heigo, which we'll just give you a heads up, is pretty light.
Calling it a tank is pretty loose.
Yeah, it's more of an armored shed, but we'll go for our deployment now. Wave 1, we've got two regular squads, two medical teams. Wave 2, we have 2 3-inch mortars, the Type 95 Heigo with its mighty 6 to 12 millimeters of armor. We have 2 20 millimeter anti-tank squads because they are fantastic. The Type 97, that is. And wave 3, we have 2 more regular squads, a 75 millimeter captured howitzer, supply crate, an officer, and a tank crew for that salvage. And we are on the attack. So it's 1 star risk, 200 manpower, 100 munitions and research. We're against the Brits once again. And the map is Gushkovo, which is actually the first German campaign mission. So how are you feeling, Mr. Silver?
Well, we're against the Brits. This will be an easy battle.
Oh, yes. We've captured their tea supply, so there's not much they can do.
They'll be running in terror.
That's it. I will actually be running in terror if I lose my tea. Anyway, guys, we'll see you in combat in a moment. And here we are in combat. So we are here once again with Mr. Quicksilver. How are you doing, sir?
Absolutely fine and dandy.
So we have two objectives. We have objective A in the middle here, this kind of on this crossroads at the start of the village. We have our objective here in this compound with a massive trench line. So I'm guessing we're going for E first, Mr. Silver?
Yeah, E, I mean, they both suck, but let's cross the river last.
Cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you AT teams, if it allows me to switch them to you. I'm also going to give you the mortar. And I think I'm going to give you, have you got the mortar now? Oh no, I think I'm going to give you the howitzer.
I think you gave me both mortars. Let me...
No, I gave you both AT teams. That's fine, because I've got the armor, so you can... You can have both. I trust you.
Okay.
But that's good, actually, because the other howitzer will be coming in later, so it gives us time to kind of... I'm guessing we just move up to this road and consolidate our forces?
Yeah, that's sort of what I was doing.
Awesome, awesome. The tank's actually very quick. It's 45 speed, which is quite...
Yeah.
I do like that. I admit, the Japanese tanks, did you ever watch the Pacific series?
Yeah.
Oh, that was awesome when the little Japanese tank with the gun moves. You can literally tell the gun's being moved by a guy's hands, how it twists.
Right. I mean, hope is that they'll shoot an AP shell at you and it'll just go straight through.
Yeah, such a soft-skinned vehicle.
The armored shed, as you put it.
I just love how... It sounds horrible, but like how much damage the Japanese did to the Chinese. I mean, literally, like, Japanese army was not built for like actual combat on this. Like, they had so little in terms of like really strong ground forces.
Yeah.
But I've got to admit, though, anyone who's interested, watch the US at like, or read up about the US at places like Guadalcanal and sort of like insane levels of balls on those guys, because they were literally being swarmed by Japanese, like, was it tens of thousands or something?
Oh, yeah.
And then Iwo Jima, which was, I think it was the only battle where the Americans actually lost more than the Japanese. I'm talking like Japanese fortresses to the maximum level of like dug into concrete, or dug into the caves, weren't they, and things?
Yeah, and the Americans even tried to bomb it to crap or shell it. And it didn't work.
Yeah, the caves were just, I'm pretty sure that like the caves are so thick, even like the biggest battleship guns just didn't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's terrifying. But, you know, I think the Pacific's a neglected theatre for people. Like, they don't realise how, like, had all the horrible diseases, had all the horrible weather. Oh, we've got early contact, sorry. Just over there, there was he's hiding behind the tractor, it's a reconnaissance infantry. Engage! There we go.
What do we have over there?
Oh, that's loud. Oh, the tank even fired.
Sten gun.
Yeah.
Quite. Oh, there's a Bren. Okay.
Ooh! The tank chipped in. That's good, right? I'm going to bring the tank slightly up just to support. Yep. Mortar's going to set up as well.
sort of swinging around the side a little.
Yeah, the tank.
There's not a lot of terrain.
I'm going to try and push kind of fairly forward. The tank's going to probably make a good mess of them there. Oh, the tank actually shot my own troops there. That's no good. Oh, what gun's that? Is that the tank? It turns out the tank's machine gun is super loud.
Oh, my AT gun. It's like firing with my AT gun.
My god, that tank machine gun is very loud.
Very cool noise, though.
Yeah, it's like very chunky. Love it.
Yeah.
I'm going to push the tank slightly out to the road. I know it's a little bit risky, but I'm not seeing much AT-wise.
Yeah.
And I'm going to bring half of my squad just to push down to the trenches down here to cover our eastern approach.
Okay.
The mortars also... With the...
I'm pushing around the west a little.
Copy that. We'll keep them busy, and then you get the good flank on them. I like it. Oh, I do like this tank, actually. Surprisingly more than I thought.
Where's my other AT?
What is weird, they have that side machine gun on the tank, on the turret.
Yeah.
It's kind of pointless.
Well, you know. Maybe,
Japanese.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, I do like the little, the whole machine gun's pretty good. I imagine one's firing.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's going to hear anything of me speaking when it's firing, so that's a bonus. Oh, we've got. I'm just going to bring these up. So you've got a squad of infantry at the back. I'll give you the tank crew. Do you want the howitzer or are you not bothered?
You can take the howitzer.
Cool. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to roll the howitzer up to kind of middle point with the ammo crate, but it'll probably take about 50 hours.
Yeah.
But that's okay. And I'm going to give you the officer. Because you are the commander here. But we can just keep continuing the assault.
You just decreased his life expectancy by quite a bit.
Well, for the Emperor, my friend.
You ever watch my German Conquest series?
Yeah, I've noticed him. Yeah.
Officer's teleport.
Oh my god, that machine gun is amazing. Oh, got that shot there. I'm actually surprised how good this tank is.
You just don't let anything touch it.
Yeah, it's definitely a glass hammer, but... Oh, they've got a Vickers machine gun at the back. I'm going to have to try and take that. Okay.
Also a mortar? Oh, no. That's the Vickers. Okay. It's just on a weird little stand.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Cleared. And I'm going to send the infantry forward. Oh, mortar should be chipping in soon. Oh, good shot with the AT rifle, dude.
Yeah, that was a good angle.
My god, the tank's brutal. There we go, machine guns down.
Right, so
we're going to push into the trench.
Over here.
There we go, got another.
Operation flanking maneuver, go, go, go.
That's it.
Actually, what I will do.
Brits is obviously very light support wise. They've got a lot of infantry, but not much support weaponry.
Yeah, and the Vickers, I'm not. It's not
great.
A great weapon.
No. So most of the British weapons weren't great. I'm not gonna lie. As someone who's British, I can say that quite unbiasedly.
Yeah. Ooh. Getting frisky with the armored shed.
Yeah, the armored shed surprised me. I'm getting a bit ballsy with it, but I do like it. I'm gonna send a couple of guys just to clear the buildings. That was a very good assault, though. Well done with the flank, dude. I like the rotating round the trenches. We kind of denied them a good face on us.
Yeah, I was a little worried about it, but. They seem very lightly defended over here.
Yeah, I'm wondering what the reinforcements are. I'm just going to trigger a grenade. Oh, he's on the floor there. Nice. Oh, I'm also getting a bit cheeky.
Okay, I think turn my mortar off.
Oh, the building's completely gone. I just realised, the building's completely eliminated by the tank and mortar rounds.
So what I'm going to try to do with my officer... See if he will. Yes, he will. Bino the other objective.
Oh. Oh, right. That's a lot of troops.
Yeah, howitz... grouped up.
Yeah, the howitz is going to set up soon and start slowly engaging.
Alright, so I'll just leave my officer like that so he can...
Yeah. Oh, the howitz only has a range of 170 meters, so he's going to have to go basically where that destroyed bridges. which is a shame.
Okay.
I'll move my infantry to the left side. I've still got that 5-man squad lingering. Just gonna get a nice shot of the tank because it looked absolutely awesome. To be fair, I do quite like the look of the tank.
Yeah.
Definitely a cool looking tank. Let's get over there.
It is very cute.
Yes, yeah, it's a cool looking, a bit of a unique design, I've got to say.
Man, they have tons of infantry over there.
Yeah, they definitely stacked them up. I'm probably going to relocate my mortar to the kind of centre as well, ready for when the assault begins. I'm also going to relocate all my infantry to the trench line down here. The tank's chipping in anyway, which is good. Oh, they're definitely
Nice
chipping
shot.
in. Yeah, they got a couple of hits on, but the howitzer's about to set up, so that's going to change quite quickly. There
Oh
we go.
yeah.
Howitzer's just going to start plowing away at him. Ooh! American howitzer, definitely high quality.
Yeah, that's 75 millimeter. It's pretty agile too.
Yeah, it's very quick actually. I'm
I
surprised at
believe
the
they
speed.
paradrop those in.
Really? Wow.
They
That's actually.
can sort of take it apart and drop it in pieces.
Well, is that kind
There's
of.
a
Was it like.
mortar right there.
Was it the. Oh, yeah. Was it the Locust as well? The US Locust. Ooh. They've got
Might
it.
be.
Yeah, there's a very light tank designed to basically put in gliders and things.
Yeah. Well, the
Yeah.
British have a Tetrarch.
Oh, that was awful.
Yeah, but they glided it in, I believe.
Yeah, I think the. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the US could do that with the. Was it the Greyhound? You could actually strip plates of it and get it in as well.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I've got to admit the gliders were surprisingly good. Like, they sound like a horrible idea, but they worked pretty well.
They
Excuse
brought in
me.
17 pounders, or the Americans, so what would that be?
Yeah, I think.
Brits with their pound to millimeter ratio.
Yeah, the pounder thing still confuses me when they're like, oh, it's an 8-pounder. You're like, what is that? We don't know.
Oh, your tank is getting obliterated.
Oh, what did I get hit by? Oh, pull back, pull back. Was that a
Oh, they have a
two?
2-pounder.
Copy that. Hit the deck. We're gonna
And
get
then
pounced for it.
a Humber, but I think AT guns might be able to take that out. I've both
Switch
set
it.
up.
Yeah, I'm gonna start hitting the Humber as well, dude. Didn't realize the tank was being hit. I've hit the Humber. So I think he's pretty smashed. I'll put another one in. He's
Yeah,
down.
both of my AT rifles are shooting it.
Nice. It's definitely down from the howitzer hit. Right. Oh, is that the 2-pounder there? That's naughty.
Yeah.
Right. Not anymore.
Right. I'm just setting up in the town because there's a little.
Copy that. I'm setting my infantry just towards the river with the mortar to support. Also got my medics ready to engage. I'll keep a couple of troops.
Move my tank crew up.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and heal that tank. Sorry, Mr. Armored Shed, you did well though. You did very well.
It lasted longer than it would have if I were using it.
I'm quite surprised at how well it did. Sorry, for a little bit loggy. And there we go, that's pretty effective to be fair.
Yeah, Humber went down nice. Take
Very
the two
effectively.
pounders down. That is a big infantry push over there.
It
Okay.
sure is. Do you have your mortar over there still?
Yes.
Fantastic. I'll switch a couple of my boys to that trench as well to support you.
Oh, their mortar's back up again now.
Oh crap. Guys, start repairing that tank. Quick, quick.
No, we took it down.
Nicely done.
Okay.
Got some
Come
guys going
on,
to support
target
you.
these guys.
Is that
There we go.
a. Oh,
Mortar's
that's.
firing.
They've got the M-field, so that's quite a nasty, nasty weapon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mortar's chipping on the main point. My guys are going to start moving up. Howitzer's just going to chip in. Is he firing? No?
Oh yeah, mortar just did a
Ooh.
bunch of damage there.
That's a fantastic shot. He's getting the Medal of Honor. Or was the Japanese equivalent here? The Emperor's Medal or something.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm
The
not
Bonsai
very up to
Cross.
speed there. Yeah, the bonsai cross. Bonsai!
Obviously, not many people received it in person.
It's a banana, but it's a bonsai cross. Just
oh, that'd be nice, actually. Can you make it a banana split?
Isn't there a thing called, like, a bonsai tree or something?
Yeah, a little bonsai tree, yeah.
There we go, that's what they're getting. Oh, you're assaulting. There you go.
Oh, yeah, I just kind of went for it. I thought they're a bit thin on troops, and obviously, once they started smashing the tank, I got a bit like, oh, if we wait here, they're going to bring more big stuff.
Yeah, no, that's a good idea.
You've done a good job on the hold there, because they sent quite a big counterattack, to be fair.
Yeah, I figured they would do that, so I sort of positioned my guys just in case.
I'm going to use this Lambo machine gun.
There's another counterattack coming.
Yeah, it looks like there's a few people here as well. Oh, you got a big push on there.
Trying to grab that mortar again. Kill him!
Whoa! Good
that
shot.
Went straight through him.
Jesus.
Poor Brits. Well,
these troops are taking a good punch in.
Yep, they're just sending more and more.
Yeah, they got a lot of troops. Keep up the good defense, dude. There we go, looks like... Oh, more! Oh, Christ. This British guy's got an AT rifle, let's take him down. There we go.
Yeah, can't have him taking out the armor
to kill
shed.
My guy. Damn it. Oh, he's definitely dead. Oh, no, he can be healed, that's good. Oh, the armored shed, is he? He's still kicking, I think. I think I'm going back online.
Yeah, so yeah. It's just another infantry squad out there. I don't...
Nice.
Oh, that's what it's doing. It's, they're trying to shoot my guys there. I'll pull them back a little, see if
armored shed's back online. Just like the Pacific now, the little turret blasting away.
They have a flank shot on your guys right here.
Flank shot? Oh, yeah, copy that.
Yeah, they're sort of around the...
Yeah, I'll just... the howitzer should be able to engage if he's not... Oh, he's a bit out of range there, unfortunately. Oh, we've got armored vehicle coming. That is a Humber. I'm going to have to use the tank to move up, I think. Oh, he's still immobilized.
And there's a mortar right there.
Copy that. We'll keep continuing if you want, so we can salvage some stuff.
Yep,
I'm just going to split my troops up a bit, because they're going to get murdered. Ooh! Talk about
murdered. Yeah, let's see. Can I move my AT rifle up? It's a little too late. Ooh! Yeah, you need both my AT rifles.
Oh my god, the cover's gone. Oh man, fall back!
That was a big push by then.
Oh yeah, that was quite smart. Oh, he is coming in range of the howitzer though, so... The Humber's not that... Oh, it's a universal carrier, actually.
Oh, can I hit that?
Yeah, I'm gonna finish you off a high X. I think that should clear him out. There we go, he's down.
Sit down. Oh, you got it, okay.
Yeah. We do have a... Said they had something in the back there. Let's get the SMG guy up just to check.
Well, those guys are running a little low on ammo. I'm going to run them to your ammo box.
Copy that. Oh, it's a couple of troops. Oh, they had a mortar, but he's down. Oh, that Humber's coming, though. Now I'm playing a bit of hide and seek.
Yeah, I'm not quite there with my...
I'm going to bring the tank up anyway. The tank's going to be head up and engaging, because I think he's only got a machine gun on it. Yeah, he does, so it's not too bad.
Not sure about this hill.
Yeah, if you just wait, I'm going to bring the tank up, because a bit unfair on your AT guns trying to... Oh, actually, you might be alright. Tank's moving up, armor piercing loaded. Let's do it.
I think my AT gun is attempting to do something. Oh no!
Tank's there, he's
ready. Us!
Fire! Do you fire or not? Oh, he's firing, fantastic, keep firing.
Oh no, my AT, one of my guns is out of ammo.
Cover that.
Run back to the ammo box!
Get a bit closer and engage that armored car. Ooh. Gun's a bit weak to it. Oh, his machine gun's actually penetrating us, what? Oh no, we're finishing. Yes, I think we got him. He's down, he's down.
I'm out of ammo on the other one now.
Oh. Is that our mortar or theirs? I think that's ours, isn't it?
Yeah, because they had one... Yeah,
just
it's
over
down.
Here, yeah. It's down.
Yeah,
cool.
You're on it now.
Awesome.
Okay, there's another small infantry...
think there's a tank crew somewhere. Where is the tank squad?
This is like Fredericksburg. They're trying to cross the river, up the hill into the fortified.
Is that a Civil War, I'm guessing?
Yeah, American Civil War.
Civil War, though, is like one of the kind of craziest wars when you look into it. Like a mix of like modern weapons with kind of Napoleonic tactics. It's very.
Oh, yeah.
I remember, was it like they had French, obviously some sides had French, some sides had British, like foreign advisors?
Yep.
And when they, so I think it was one of the battles, they were just stood there shooting each other in the lines, like, why don't you fix the bayonets and charge? And they were just, one of some of these generals, like, what do you mean? It's like, yeah, you don't stand here and just shoot each other for 4 hours. Like, you don't? It's like, nope.
Yeah.
But to be fair, like, I've got to say, the Civil War's kind of, it's very, kind of cool. Like, well, it's not cool how many people died, but some really cool battle. Like, literally, I read about bodies being stacked like 5 foot high in some battles.
Yeah, it was devastating. That's one of the games I want to put on my channel is a Civil War game.
Okay, which one's that?
Ultimate Admiral, or sorry, Ultimate General Civil War.
Ah, well,
same everyone, people that make the Ultimate Admiral game, but
yeah, everyone tune in, go watch and play Ultimate General Civil War, because I think I've seen that advertised. Isn't it? Is it like you have like a grand campaign and then go into tactical battles?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Cool. So, yeah, I like that kind of stuff. Kind of like, especially with Civil War, because it will be just, I imagine the casualties will be high.
Yeah, unfortunately, there's a lot of casualties.
Was it?
Unlike this battle, well, I think you took some.
Yeah, I always take casualties.
I'm much more, as I said, you gave me some praise there. I think I'm a little bit more like Montgomery. Like,
no, I think,
should we attack? No, let's sit back.
So I have this thing where I always try and like jump straight into the first objective, thinking like, oh, people don't want to watch me screw around, but I'll be like 4 minutes into a match and be like, oh, this is dragging on. So I just charge in and I'm like, yeah, like maybe I should let the battles last an hour because I'd probably save a lot of men. I'm definitely a cluster in that sense.
Right.
But yeah, having the slow methodical approach, like some people say, oh, you get more reinforcements against you, but if you have good firing lines like you did there at the objective E, think how many people you killed, you didn't lose anything, whereas I tend to leave a lot of defensive points understaffed, and then I tend to lose them.
Yeah, I mean, that was a bloodbath over here.
Yeah, there's a lot of bodies over there, like that's at least a squad or two just in the woods alone, and they were fairly well armed, I think. Lamfields, yeah, Stens. I didn't see too many elite infantry, but those little, what the dingoes, are they?
Humbers,
yeah, they're not. But yeah, that machine gun actually penetrated. It damaged the hull on the tank.
Yeah.
So that's kind of scary. I've got to say, though, the tank, quite impressed. He got 35 infantry kills and 2 vehicle kills.
General Sheba can talk to you about dingoes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, one did try to eat his baby.
But no, the British dingo is more like I don't know. It's like a mix between a jeep and a universal carrier.
I'm trying to think, yeah, I'm trying to, but I do. The Humber's not bad. To be fair, of all the like old vehicles, that looks kind of more modern than most of them.
Yeah, so I mean it has
nice sloped armor on it. It's got a 7.62/57mm machine gun, but it's like a long-barreled machine gun. Has it got a cannon though?
I think it's an autocannon with a machine gun.
Oh, but the cannon's not showing up, but it must be a cannon, yeah, because it's got a big old gun. No wonder it did some damage there. Maybe the cannon shot through me. I thought it just had an SMG, so I'm very lucky I didn't get hit by that.
Yeah, and my gunners ran out of ammo at the worst possible moment.
I've got to say, those AT guns are good, but they are very trigger-happy. Very trigger-happy.
Yes. Well, because they have... Oh, it's an 8-round clip.
Ow.
And they just blow through it so fast.
Yeah, it's good though, it's so fast fire. Like, it reminds me about the Finnish AT rifle, ironically, the 10 round clip one's just really weak, just basically nothing. Yeah. And it's quite like donk, donk, whereas this one's just.
Oh, douche, it does douche. Have HE.
Yeah, I use the HE rounds, they're quite 20mm, they're quite punchy.
Wow.
So, yeah, once again, really we've stolen most of the British army here. So, is that ever since salvaged?
Yep. I've grabbed the other guns.
That was fantastic. Anyway, we will just have a quick look at the casualty screen. And 125 kills and only 7 losses. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I thought you lost more, so that's really good.
Yeah, I think I healed a couple. I think I did get hit with that mortar, so yeah, I thought I'd lost more, but actually I think it's because when I assaulted, they only had a 5-man squad on the first assault, so maybe it looked a bit worse.
Yeah, no, but you killed the most.
But you got 48-1 kill death ratio. That's John Wick levels.
48-1, we yeah. win.
That's it. That's fantastic. Anyway, we'll see in the rearmament screen in a moment, Jordan. And here we are at the rearmament screen. We've got 425.5 manpower, 1 support star, 100 munitions, and 5 research points. And Mr. Silver, how did you think that went?
That was super easy. Mid-afternoon tea, cotton with their pants down.
Fantastic. Yeah, the Humber does have a... First gun is a cartridge 7.62 57mm machine gun. The second one's the 15mm autocannon, which is a weird number.
Well, it is British.
Yes. So they probably
it's
made
either in inches, millimeters, or pounds.
Yes. So do you want to just get rid of the I imagine?
Yeah. I mean, you know, we don't know how to drive that.
No. We'll get rid of the boys' gun carrier as well.
Yeah.
Correct. We did get 2 more mortars, so shall we dump them?
Yeah, 2 mortars seems like enough.
And we got a Vickers machine gun, which we definitely don't need, do we?
Yeah, that thing's trash. I think it's one of the worst machine guns.
We'll rearm everything. We've got everything's rearmed. We've got 1,599 manpower spare, 6.2 research points, and 755 munitions. So I think that's been a fantastic third episode, and I hope you have as well.
It's a great start.
Fantastic. Anyway, guys. Once again, the link will be in the bottom of the description for Quicksilver's stuff. He's got some great Osfront content and many more historical games coming. So do get over there, get subscribed, give him some love, and we will see you on the next episode. That's goodbye from me.
As always, until next time.
Thanks for watching, everyone. You guys have a fantastic evening.